Hello friends and good day, this is Fred with Tech Talk and I'm coming at you today with a quick video on what you can do if you have or your client has forgotten the administrative password to log into your Dahua IP camera. Okay, there's a way to restore these cameras to factory default without the administrative password. And when you do so, when the camera reboots, it will prompt you to create an administrative password. Okay, for today's demonstration, we are going to use a Dahua WizMind Night Color camera. This model is N45YN2. Okay, it's a great IP camera. Let's get into it now. All right, let's get into the meat and potatoes. Before we do, you know the drill. There is a subscribe button in the bottom right-hand corner of your screen. If you have not yet subscribed to our YouTube channel, please click that and subscribe so you'll be notified when we post future content just like this. Also, like the video if it's useful to you, and as always, leave comments. We can't say it enough. A lot of these videos are based on subscriber questions and comments. Okay, so let's get into it. All right, so here we have the Dahua N45YN2 4 megapixel IP dome. This process is very similar for most of Dahua's IP cameras. So it matter not if you have a dome or a bullet. Somewhere on the camera, okay, you will see the SD cover, okay? This is where the micro SD memory card will go. This is also where the reset button is. In fact, I don't know if you can see it on the video or not. This actually says reset right on it. Okay, so we're gonna remove these two screws. It is a hex bit. So if you have the wrench that the camera came with, that would be the best thing to use. But if you don't have it, you can get a hex bit set, much like a Allen wrench kit at Home Depot or Lowe's, even Walmart, and it will have this star bit. Okay, once we loosen these up, this cover will come off, okay? And as I said, there is a slot in there for your micro SD storage, okay? We've had previous videos on how to install the micro SD cards. There's a video link going across your screen right now walking you through how to use that micro SD chip slot. But what we're focused on, what we're concerned about today, is if you look right here, you will see the words reset, okay? And inside of that slot, there is a little black button. You can see it right there. You're gonna have to press that with a pen. Okay, I am actually going to use a needle that my wife has for sewing, and I'm going to press this, okay? What you're gonna do is you're gonna press and hold this at the same time that you plug the PoE plug into your power source, okay? So you're gonna hold the pin down, you're gonna plug this in. Once it's plugged in, you're gonna continue to hold this for about 20 seconds, okay? 20 to 30 seconds. Once it's completely rebooted, you're going to release the pin and this camera will in fact reset to factory defaults and it will allow you the opportunity to reset the administrative password. So I'm going to pull this up on a laptop. All right, friends, so we have pulled up our camera using Dahua's config tool. If you have not previously downloaded the config tool from Dahua Wiki, there is a link going across the screen right now teaching you how to download and use this tool. Basically, it's Hikvision's equivalent to SADP. Okay, it's a management software that lets you identify Dahua hardware on your network. And as we can see, here is our N45EYN2. The nice things about these particular cameras, about the WizMind cameras, is they are shipped in DHCP. So they'll ship and they will automatically transition to your network. Some of the less expensive Dahua cameras, they ship with a static IP address of 192.168.1.108. So when you plug them into your network, you'd identify them with the config tool. You'd have to change your gateway to log into the camera and change your administrative password that way. Luckily, this camera transitioned to our gateway. So we're going to pull it up at 192.168.0.27 right now. And again, the very cool thing about Dawa is you can pull these cameras up using Edge, right? Hikvision, we've talked about it before. It likes old school Explorer because of all the plugins. The new computers, Windows computers with Windows 11, no longer have Explorer. So to log into those cameras, you need to put Edge in legacy mode, and it's a bit of a hassle. So this is a good thing with Dawa. So yes, the camera has been reset to factory defaults. We're going to select our region. I'm in the United States, so that is what I'm going to pick. We're going to leave it English language and NTSC. Okay. We're going to accept their software license agreement. We're going to update our time. We're on Eastern time. We're going to sync the time to our PC. We're going to hit next. Here we're going to create the administrative password. Look at that. To something we will not forget. Now, this is very important. The Dawa equipment does have the option for you to enter an email address that will allow you to reset the password in the future should you lose it. You won't have to go through the hassle of getting to the camera, taking the SD slot cover off, hitting the reset button just like we did. You'd be able to do this through the software if you put your email address in here. So be sure to do that. Hit next. If you want to use Dawa's DMSS phone app, you would download the DMS phone app to your phone through the App Store. There's a link going across the top of your screen right now walking you through how to do that. But once you do that, once you download the DMSS app, all you need to do is scan this QR code and it will configure your phone to work with the serial number of this IP camera without an NVR. Okay. And if you put a SD card in the micro SD slot, you don't need an NVR to record either. Okay. So it's a pretty cool deal. We'll hit next here. We want it to auto check for updates to make sure we have the latest firmware. And right now we should be able to log into this camera with the new password we just created. There it is in my living room looking at the wall, but it is online. Okay. So that is it in a nutshell, my friend. It's not a difficult process. Just open that SD slot cover, hit the reset button. As you power up the device, hold the button for about 20 to 30 seconds, let go, and the camera will reboot in factory default mode. Hope everybody's enjoying their day. We'll see you in the field.